call.
Thanks, Mr. President. I seek leave to make a brief statement before addressing a question without notice to the Minister for Health on the topic of the COVID-19 vaccine rollout for those experiencing homelessness.
Is leave granted? Leave is granted. The Honourable Mr. Sims.
Thank you. Back in July, the government announced its trial COVID-19 vaccination clinic for South Australians experiencing homelessness in the city as part of its outreach program. With an estimated 6,000 people in South Australia currently experiencing homelessness, organisations that support homeless people are calling for them to be prioritised as part of the rollout. My questions to the minister are: how many people experiencing homelessness have received their first and second vaccination? What is the process for ensuring follow-up appointments for full vaccinations are kept? And what is the timeline for moving beyond a trial phase that is confined simply to the city?
Minister for Health and Wellbeing is the call.
I thank the honourable member for his question. The Marshall Government is determined to ensure that every South Australian has access to the COVID-19 vaccine as soon as possible to keep our state safe and our economy strong. We have a particular focus on vulnerable people in our community. SA Health has been working with the new homelessness alliances to ensure that service providers are engaged in the planning for the delivery of the vaccine in the homeless sector. The alliances include providers who deliver services to homeless people, from those sleeping rough, couch surfing or sleeping in cars, to those suffering domestic and family violence. The rollout will continue in partnership with the sector, SA Health and SA Ambulance, with a tailored approach to the vaccination of people experiencing homelessness. It was my privilege on the 9th of July 2021 to launch the rollout for people sleeping rough at Westcare in Wright Street. It was particularly my privilege because my father was the superintendent at Westcare for some years. South Australia's vaccine rollout program continues to gather momentum as vaccine supply increases. Some of the points I was making in my previous answer are directly relevant here too. We've been working with different service providers to work out what would work best for their particular service group. So, for example, in relation to one service, we provided specific clinics at the Women's and Children's Hospital. In the northern suburbs, dedicated Aboriginal clinic has been established, and we continue to look at opportunities to expand service provision to the Aboriginal community. In relation to the point the honourable member makes about second doses, one of the strategies to facilitate the completion of the vaccine cycle is to, an outreach service to come back at the relevant time after their first visit. But also, SA Health does continue to provide a callback service through the local health networks to promote the need for a second dose. In our regions, SA Health is working with local providers of services and offering the vaccine across several sites. Whilst it's on the point the honourable member made in terms of coverage, it is difficult to determine how many homeless people have been vaccinated, as it's not an identifier that is used for recording purposes in the Australian Immunisation Register. The Marshall Government will continue in our efforts to ensure that it is widely available. Homeless people are continuing to be a priority for this government during the pandemic. Your members would recall that during the first wave, the honourable member for Minister for Human Services facilitated hotel accommodation to protect homeless citizens. We are all in this together, and none of us is safe from the virus until we're all safe from the virus. The honourable member expressed concern, first of all, that it was a pilot, and secondly, were we being city-focused? This issue was raised on the 9th of July. It was never a pilot in the sense that we were we were seeing whether we liked the idea. The fact is we are committed to outreach services, as I said in my previous answer. So it was a pilot in the sense that, being an outreach service from the mass vaccination clinic at Wayville, did this model work? And the fact that the model does work is reflected on the fact that we are continuing to deliver these types of services. So, for example, last week our mobile vaccination clinics visited a range of sites, including sites at which homeless people would often be engaged. For example, we had mobile vaccination clinics at Central Dasa, the Hutt Street Centre, the West Care Day Centre, Common Ground, Aldinga Community Centre, the Noolunga Aboriginal Family Clinic, the Hackham West Community Centre, the Christie's Downs Community House. I'm delighted that we have we're now moving into the period where supplies of the vaccine are significantly increasing, because that will give us even more opportunities to reach out to vulnerable communities or vaccine-hesitant communities.
Sims.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I thank the Minister for his comprehensive response. I note his statement that it is difficult to. I note his statement that it's difficult to get data on people who are experiencing homelessness and those who have received the vaccination.
Question there, Mr.
Will
Sims.
Will he give an undertaking, however, that he will share the information that he does have with this place?
There's the call.
I certainly will. We'll see if I can get further information. As I said, the air data doesn't record immunisation, so it doesn't have the. We would have to be using other means.